So continuing on with regards to your social prowess, young leaders often get pushback from seasoned professionals due to their lack of experience. That's not new. So how do you navigate these situations? And what soft skills do you use to make these conversations easier?
Yeah, to me, that's such a phenomenal question, because the reality is experience is this double-edged sword. Everyone expects you to have experience, but in order to get experience, you have to be there to create that moment. I know a middle manager of mine in the past used to say, he used to ask me a question and say, how long does it take, Kyle, to get 20 years of experience? Well, by definition, while it's such a simple question, the reality is we're also always trying to figure out how to do that faster, right? But by definition, 20 years is 20 years. So to me, the best piece of advice I think I could give someone, and the piece of advice I routinely give, for whether it be an entry-level college engineer or someone that's just trying to learn and be part of it, is be present. The best way to learn is to be there when it happens, right? That does not mean working 24 hours a day, 365 days a year. What it does mean is if you hear something on the radio, if you're carrying the radio, if you see an email that a group is troubleshooting and doesn't understand what's going on with a process upset, if you hear about a bearing that we're watching that may about to fail, be there for the event to be able to ask the technicians, the operators, the engineers, the people that are deeply involved in that problem and the troubleshooting. If you're there and you're seen as a sponge, people will truly go out of their way to help you, because they'll see the fact that this employee, this young individual that doesn't have experience is at least trying to get it, right? So I think far too often people will feel overwhelmed to try to get in the middle of something going on because they feel disconnected from it. But the best way to break through that glass is just to do it, right? So if you just break through and realize step one is accept the fact that I don't know, and step two, be willing to ask, being present is the best way to make all of that happen. And in doing that, you're then seen as someone that's on the team, your results will improve, your engagement in the team will improve, and your ownership of the team, which all of that ties together, right? So while it seems so simple, I think the courage to do that is very real. And it's very easy for someone to say to a 22-year-old, 24-year-old, whatever it is, a few years out of school, we'll just be there. Right. But step one is recognizing that. And step two is building the courage just to do it and know that at some point in time, the most experienced person was in that exact same footprint, whatever years ago it was. Right. So how do you close that gap of experience? Start by being present. And the rest usually takes care of itself.
I think that really highlights your soft skill of, you know, just being personable, not being, you know, that individual that's just going to, I'm going to focus on my stuff and not worry about other people's problems, or I'm just going to, you know, sit in my office and do the things that I need to do. It's getting out there, asking the questions, actually having a personal connection with the, you know, the employees that you know are going to have to help you down the road. I think that this answer really highlights that. And again, as we've talked about, you're a very personal individual. It's very clearly helped you in your leadership roles coming out of school and even now. So I really like that answer, Kyle.
Thank you. Yeah, really, if you think about what this entire platform is, talking about soft skills with young engineers, it all ties together, right? The reality is all of these different skills that we talk about, all of the different skills we're expected to have, all start with soft skills, because soft skills gives you that avenue. It opens the door for you to experience that many different people, different backgrounds, and things you would otherwise not naturally do, right? So the soft skills is what ties it all together. It's what makes a company, because a company is full of people, right? And you can't do those things by being individuals and being robots. We have to work together to make that happen. And soft skills is how we do that. So to me, I think overall the fact that this group is promoting that through the TAPI organization, I think is just exactly what we need to be doing right now.